Yo, what's up everybody? Anthony again here, back again with another episode for you guys on the Solo Tradecraft YouTube channel. If you guys haven't already, join the Facebook group that we have. Link is in the comments below. But depending on when you guys are watching this video, this weekend I'm about to go fly out to Canada along with my colleagues Fernando and Nick of Solo Tradecraft. And we're gonna get to speak in Toronto. It's gonna be super awesome. I've never been in Canada. Well, I've been once when I was a kid, but I don't think that really counts. So this time is going to be the first real time I get to go to Canada. I'm super excited for it. And it's another speaking event that I get to go to. This will probably be like my fourth one I've ever done in the Amazon space. You know, public speaking is a little scary to me. Even talking on a camera, like, I'm not used to this, right? It's a different thing than I'm used to in like my everyday life. But I know, like, you know, when you're uncomfortable, it makes you grow as a person, right? So just, you know, some food for thought, keep that in your head. When you're uncomfortable, you're gonna grow as a person. But anyways, let me jump straight into the video about what we're gonna go over today. So today we're gonna talk about Amazon PPC, and we're gonna talk about how you can really push your exact campaigns on Amazon a little bit more. How are we gonna do that? Okay, all we're gonna do is copy the keywords that you already have in your exact, your phrase, or your, you know, whatever campaigns you have right now, put it in a typo generator, right? The typo generator is gonna help you find all these typos, which, you know, I have bad spelling, a lot of people on this planet have bad spelling, right? So, you know, Amazon's pretty good at auto-correcting, but sometimes they don't auto-correct the stuff correctly for us, right? So why not bid on these keywords? They're gonna be super cheap. They're gonna be long tail keywords that no one's competing for. And the more long tail keywords that you're ranking for on the first page, guess what's gonna happen to your sales? It's gonna go up. Guess what's gonna happen to your profits? It's gonna go up. You know, like, everything's gonna go up. Your keyword ranking, what's gonna happen? It's gonna go up. But yeah, at the end of the day, you know, winning all these long tail keywords is gonna help you win those main keywords too, right? Because the more sales you get, the more Amazon's gonna put you up and up and up and up. All right, so how do we do this? All right, so I have a couple things pulled up right now. So I have my keywords all pulled into a, okay, so these are like, say, my initial keywords. I have a list of them. So I'll just copy and paste all of them. And what you do is you're gonna go to this website called tools.seobook.com. Link is gonna be in the comments below, so don't worry about that. But essentially, it's just a keyword typo generator. I personally will go ahead and use every single one of these typo things, and I'll just hit generate typo. And it'll just generate right there below, and I'll go ahead and I like to copy and paste into an Excel document just to save. But it's gonna generate like 60,000 different keywords, which is kind of overkill. But if there's, I don't know, maybe 1% or like a couple hundred thousand keywords where you're getting like really good ACOS on it, then it's totally worth it at the end of the day, right? This doesn't hurt to do. And it takes less than 5 minutes to do. Like, your VAs can be doing this. I don't actually do this, my VAs do this, right? So tell your VAs to watch this video so they know how to do this, okay? So once we get the typos, what you're gonna wanna do is create a new campaign. This is the way I do it. So my naming conventions, I use the SKU, right? And then I'll type typo, right? So I know this is like the typo collection. And then I'll type exact, because we're only gonna use exact. And I'll set my daily bid to $10. I won't set an end date, and it'll be manual targeting, right? So let's continue to the next step. This is the point where you're gonna select like your product that you are gonna advertise for. So in this example, I will just select a random product, and it's gonna be blurred, right? Blur, so you guys don't know what it is at the end of the day, all right? But, okay, so go to provide your own keywords right here, and then you're gonna copy and paste it, all right? And it's gonna take a while, right? Sometimes just because there's a lot of keywords you're entering. And then you're gonna also change this to exact. Remember, that's really important. We're just gonna just do exact. We don't wanna mess with broad or phrase. And then once you hit add these keywords, your computer might freeze. Just saying. So you might have to do this in a couple different chunks, because as soon as you click this, it's gonna load into Amazon. It's gonna take a little bit while to just have all the keywords in there, and it's gonna be a little bit slow. And I'll set the default bid to 20 cents. That's what I'll usually do. I don't want it too high, just in case it's like some random keyword that goes off the high end. But other than that, this is something you want to be checking weekly. Like your PPC, if you aren't already, you should be checking it weekly to see how it's doing week on week. And then if any of these are winners, move them into your like normal exact campaigns, right? Go ahead and do that. But essentially at the end of the day, this is a super easy trick to really push your Amazon PPC campaign, right? Just adding typos, adding misspellings, right? Because people misspell all the time, right? So typos are one way, and then another way is using different languages, right? So you can use Google Translate and do all of that. And then that's another scenario, right? But in this video, I'm gonna concentrate on typos. But if you want to, throw these into Google Translate, and that's another way to do it too. But other than that, you know, I'm Anthony. Thanks for watching. If you guys enjoyed this video, please leave me a comment below and give me a thumbs up. And if you guys want me to make any other videos on certain topics, right? Or if you guys have any questions, please leave it in the comments below, and that's where I'll get back to you, respond to you, and I'll look at it to make future videos, right? But other than that, thanks for watching and subscribe to the Seller Tradecraft channel. I'm out. See ya.